Hello everyone, my name is Shani Hu, Sangfor HCI Product Manager. In this video, I'd like to explain to you how we achieve high performance on the storage layer of our HCI. As some of you may have already been familiar with our solution, we are utilizing SSD and HDD as a hybrid configuration for our storage. SSD serves as the cache layer and HDD serves as the data layer. Because SSD has much higher performance than HDD, so the performance can be boosted. Based on that, we are also leveraging data striping technology. This technology came out with our 5.8.6 version, and with data striping, the performance of our aSAN has been improved significantly. So let's take a look at how data striping works on aSAN. So here, I've drawn a 3-node cluster. On each node, there are 2 SSDs and 6 HDDs. They form 2 disk groups. Here, with 1 SSD and 3 HDDs, this is disk group 1, and we can call this disk group 2. And the same applies to the other 2 nodes. And when we store data, VM's data, on our aSAN, it is stored as a QCal2 file. So let's say we have a QCal2 file here. This is the QCal2. You can consider it as an equivalent of a virtual disk for our virtual machine running on HCI. And when I create a VM, when I initialize my VM, there will be a stripe width that is automatically created, automatically configured by the HCI platform. In this case, we will have a stripe width as 6. Okay, this stripe width, the number of the stripe width cannot be larger than the minimum number of hard disk drives on any particular node in the cluster. And so, accordingly, the QCal2 will be broke down into 6 fragments. This is fragment 1, this is fragment 2, fragment 3, fragment 4, and fragment 6. Okay, they are stored on the disk groups on a particular node. So how does this striping work on the QCal2? So when I need to write data to the virtual machine, the data will be striped. And based on the stripe width 6, it will be broken down to 6 stripes. Let's say this is stripe 1, stripe 2, stripe 3, stripe 4, stripe 5, and stripe 6. And these 6 stripes, they form as a, we call it stripe group. And these 6 fragments is called fragment group. So when I write data, the data is divided into stripes, and each stripe is 108 kilobyte in size. Okay, these stripes will be assigned to these fragments. It works like this. Stripe 1 is assigned to fragment 1, stripe 2 to fragment 2, and stripe 6 to fragment 6, and it goes on. And when you associate fragments to these groups, okay, these fragments will be stored on the disks inside the node. So fragment 1, let's say it will be start here. Fragment one will be stored on the hard drive in this group one. And here we have fragment two, fragment three, five, and six. So this fragment group will be dispersed and distributed across the disks inside the disk groups. And to make it high performing, you got to make sure that you know the fragments are distributed in as many disks as possible. And these fragments will be called as a aggregated fragment, because all of the data stripes are stored on this node while the VM is running. Let's say the VM is running here, and the qcal25, you can see qcal25, it belongs to this VM, and the fragments is distributed across the disks. So when the VM tries to read the data, okay, it reads from the local aggregated fragments. It doesn't go across, to the network, go across the network to read data from other nodes. So there is an aggregated fragment group of the VM's data. There's also a dispersed fragmented dispersed fragments of the data. So let's say here I could have a F1 here. Sorry. I could have a F1 here, F2 here, F3 here, F4 here. Maybe another F5 here and F6 here. So I have an aggregated copy of my data. I also have a dispersed copy of my data. So because we are using multiple copies on aSAN, there are at least two copies of your data. In this case, the VM reads the data from the local aggregated fragment group. It doesn't travel, the read request doesn't travel the network to induce latency. And what makes this data striping technology impressive in terms of performance is it can leverage more SSDs and more HDDs for your read and write performance, for your read and write operations. As you can see here, I have my data that is striped into different into a stripe group, and the stripe groups are stored in the fragment groups. And fragment groups is stored across different disks between disk groups. Okay? And let's say if I want to read this portion of data, and this data is created by all these stripes, I need to read these two disk groups. Okay? So I can utilize the performance of these two SSDs. And also if I need to write my data, of course the data will be written to the SSD in priority to boost the performance, and also another copy to the other SSD in the other disk groups in another node. So in that way you can see we are utilizing more SSDs and more HDDs to improve the concurrency of the disk IOs. And one more thing to keep in mind here is because data striping is used in our aSAN since 5.8.6, that means at least you gotta have one SSD for the cache, and inside one disk group there could be no more than 7 disks inside one disk group. And so with the data striping, data locality And our distributed technology with aSAN, our storage performance built by aSAN could rival the world's most advanced HCI system on the market. We have done a test. So with this architecture, we are able to achieve an average 50% more IOPS from this architecture when you compare Sangfor HCI to the other vendor's HCI solution. So really impressive. It provides great IOPS, impressive throughput from the storage architecture based on aSAN. So if you want to know more about Sangfor storage technology with our aSAN distributed architecture, please visit our official website. Thank you.